seeing ANA's 50th 787 just taxiing past. Nice little neat little insert just below the ANA and the Japanese flag there. It's a very low cloud, cover today here in Sydney. But there's also no breeze, so it means that we're not getting the rotation shots that I want. So that's the problem you get with 1/6 right. You don't get the rotations with the big ones. Especially all those trees in the background. I mean the foreground that's blocking it off. If those trees weren't there, we'd be getting some brilliant shots. But anyway, not to worry. You get some good sight on stuff anyway, so. But it does prove to be a bit of a nuisance when they do use 1/6 and there's no breeze to speak of. That's the one big disadvantage you've got to put up with. Here comes a heavy. What I'm looking out for is Philippine Airlines A350. One of these flights will be it. Maybe this might be it. Hopefully I'm not going to get a photo bomb. Definitely an A350, it's either Philippines or it might be, no, I think it is Philippines, so let's just video this and I'll be quiet so you can hear it coming. Believe it or not, Philippine Airlines have only got two A350s now. They used to have a fleet of about 10. During the coronavirus era, they offloaded 8 of them, mostly to Lufthansa. So now they've only got 2 left. But they are making a big order for some 1000s. You're gonna have to wait a few years for that because Qantas are ahead of them on the order. The big love heart on underneath the back of the cockpit there. That is Philippine Airlines A350, and otherwise known this one, the aircraft known as the Love Bus. get a bit more fearing of that Philippine Airlines. There she is, the A350. Unfortunately, just have to wait for a gate. There are a few aircraft that are pushing back. You can see American Airlines are pushing back. And United, and so quite a few of the airlines will be heading out. Vietnam Airlines will be coming back very soon as well. Well, we'll leave the video there, and thank you for watching.